Hello, all the students of Stand Up Hope. Good morning. I hope you all are well in this pandemic coronavirus. Please stay home, stay safe. Spend your quality time with your family member. You can give your quality time in your study also. Eat healthy foods, play some indoor games. Don't go outside to play and eat junk food because it is lockdown period. I hope whatever homework I am giving you in maths and science, you are doing it in your homework copy on time because whenever school is going to open, I will ask for whatever homework I have given you in Maths and Science. So please do it in your homework copy. So today I am going to teach you Science, Chapter 4, Solid, Liquids and Gases already going on. Today I am going to teach you topic Gas to Liquid. Okay? Gas to Liquid, page number 44. So whenever you are going to watch my video, please keep book and copy with you. Okay? Gas to Liquid means a water vapor to water. Okay. So the process by which a gas change into liquid on cooling is called condensation. So when water vapor cool, it condenses and changes into water. Okay, when water vapor cools, I am telling you how. When your mother boils some water, that vessels it covered with some lid. Then you will see when you will take out that lid, you will find some water droplets on the surface of the lid. Okay. It means whatever, when water boils, it gives water vapor. When water vapor rises up in the air, after that water vapor stuck on the lid of the vessel. Then after that, when you will take out the lid of the vessel, you will find some water droplets will be there. That's why it says the process by which a gas changes into a liquid, on cooling, it's called condensation. Have you observed droplets of water forming on the surface of a glass of cold milk or juice? Okay. Now these droplets form because water vapor in the air cools down when it comes in contact with the cold surface of the glass. Yes. Whenever you drink some cold drink, cold milk, cold juices, then you will find the surface of the glass. Okay. Means this side or everywhere, surface of the glass also, you will find there is water droplets there. Why? Because these droplets forms water vapor in the air, cools down. This, whatever the water droplets are there, when it comes in the contact of air, it cools down. Okay? It cools down and it cools down when it comes to the contact with the surface of the glass, and after that it condenses to form water. I have given you example also. You just boil some water. After that, from boiling of water, water vapor will come. Okay, water vapor will rise. Now, take one covered lid. Okay, with utensils, and whatever water vapor will come, we just keep it like the vessels like that. Now whatever when will it rise, it will come into contact of air. After that, when it will rise into the air, that water vapor will cool down. And when it will come to the surface of the cover that lid, utensil, that water vapor will change into water droplets. And that water droplets will be in the form of liquid. But here example is, when I am just giving the other example. Have you ever observed the droplet form? Because the dew that forms, yes, the dew that forms on leaves and flower in the morning, also water formed by the condensation of water vapor in the air. Okay, the dew when you see in the morning, when you will find on the leaves, on the tree also, on the grass also, you will find that water droplet. So that is also formed by the condensation of water vapor in the air. Okay, so one example, the dew that forms, on leaves and flowers, in the morning. In the morning, it also formed by the condensation of water vapor in the air. Just you keep in your mind. When I will give the example of this rain also, when sunlight hits the water body, river, lakes, water vapor rises up. When water vapor rises up, it cools down, okay, and it changes into water droplets. So that is also in the form of liquid. That's why it says, to the help of that condensation, that water vapor, when it rises, it changes into a liquid. Okay, students, now we move to page number 45, solutes, solvents and solution. We say solute plus solvents is equal to solution. So we have learned how matter change from one state to the other. We have already learned. But what happens when different substances in the same or different states are mixed together? Okay, now formation of a solution we will see in this. Okay, formation of a solution. So what you will do, take a glass of water, add a teaspoon of sugar to it and stir it, means mix it with a spoon for few minutes. You will observe that the sugar disappear. This is because the sugar has mixed completely with water. We say that sugar has dissolved in the water, so sugar is soluble in water. And a solution is formed when two or more substances mix together ununiformly. Generally, the substance that dissolves in another is called solute. The substance in which the solute gets dissolved is called solvent. Okay. And usually the solute is smaller in quantity than the solvent. So in a solution of sugar and water, sugar is the solute and water is the solvent. It means when we take one glass of water, we mix sugar. Okay, the sugar is called solute. Okay, and that water is called solvent. And when they mix, what? Solution is formed. So we say that when sugar is mixed in water, what form? It forms a solution. Okay, now whatever next line is there that I will explain in lecture number 2.